Does growing crops in a greenhouse seem counter to the notion of sustainability? Not if you do it right. Here are a few simple things you can do to reduce water use, reduce energy use, reduce fertilizer and chemical runoff, and even increase your income per square foot of greenhouse. A useful technology to conserve energy in a greenhouse is an energy curtain system. Energy curtains serve two purposes in the greenhouse. In the winter, they close at night to reduce heat loss through the roof. The curtain material serves as a blanket and reflects the radiant energy coming from the crop back into the greenhouse. Typically, energy curtains reduce the heating energy used in a greenhouse by 30%, which in itself is a good reason to install them. But in addition to the energy savings in the cooler months, they can also be used for cooling the greenhouse in the warmer months. Energy curtains typically provide between 50 and 70% shade, which helps to keep the greenhouse and crop cooler and reduce the vent fan operation, which also provides energy savings. High tunnels are a very energy efficient way to grow crops. Typically, they are built on parts of the farm that don't have electricity, so cooling is accomplished through natural ventilation via roll-up sides and open doors. Some greenhouses also use natural ventilation, which saves energy as well. High tunnels can be used to extend the growing season without using electricity or heat, and they also protect the crop from adverse weather and rain, thereby reducing the need for pesticides. Wise use of supplemental lighting early in the cropping cycle will shorten time to maturity. Supplemental lighting can reduce the days to harvest by 2 weeks for many spring crops. Shortening time to maturity means you can delay planting and save on heating costs. Seedlings are planted at a high density in seedling trays, so fewer lights are needed to cover the crop, as opposed to lighting a mature crop where plant spacings are much greater. So a little more energy applied at the right time saves energy overall. Space-saving technologies will reduce the energy needed to grow your crops and result in a greater income per square foot of greenhouse. Benches and trays that are fixed in place may be cheap to install, but waste a lot of valuable greenhouse floor space. The additional cost of rolling benches can be quickly recovered by the increased use of space. Dutch trays or movable pallets can also use space efficiently and reduce labor costs by efficiently moving plants in and out of the greenhouse. In some cases, growers who are growing a crop on the floor below the Dutch trays roll the trays outside during the day so the sunlight can reach the plants on the floor below. Multi-layer cropping, where hanging baskets or shelves support one crop above the other, is also a good way to increase space efficiently and reduce energy use. Placement of the upper crop needs to be done in a way to avoid dripping or dropping of flowers and leaves onto the crop below. Structures and pots designed to grow crops vertically are also being used commercially. However, I would caution you to do it on a trial basis first. The equipment can be very expensive, and shading from the structure and the upper plants causes the crop on the lower levels to stretch. Overall production with vertical systems can be higher per square foot, but improved energy efficiency and profitability are questionable. Growing on the greenhouse floor is another way to increase space utilization compared to stationary benches. Growing on the floor requires more heat because it is cooler at the floor level, unless you are using a floor heating system. A floor heating system, also called a radiant heated floor, is a very efficient way to warm a crop if you are growing on the floor. Growing on the floor with the heat provided below is both space efficient and reduces your energy use. A floor heating system is relatively easy to install, and your return on investment will be quick. You may have heard of some companies that grow plants on vertical or horizontal racks and utilize 100% artificial lighting. While this type of system is highly productive per square foot of area used, it is also very energy intensive. We would not recommend that a beginning farmer use this type of production system until the economic and sustainable benefits, if any, are better understood. Conserving water and crop production is a very important component of sustainable agriculture practices. It is even more important in greenhouse production because of the warmer temperatures, faster crop growth, and longer production season. Several types of precision irrigation systems are a good fit for greenhouses. They include drip irrigation, where every plant has a separate emitter, bottom irrigation from flooded benches or floors, and hydroponics. With all of these systems, water is applied very efficiently and the loss of water and nutrients into the ground is minimized. With flooded benches or floors and recirculating hydroponics, the water can be recovered into a holding tank and reused. Research has shown that recirculating hydroponic systems can reduce water use by as much as 90% per pound of crop grown as compared with outdoor production. Another water-saving technology used widely in Europe is a retention pond to capture rainwater from the greenhouse roof. The water in the pond can be filtered and used for irrigation in the greenhouse. This serves to minimize stormwater runoff and reduce the amount of water used from other sources to grow the greenhouse crops. In summary, consider energy curtains, high tunnels, heated floors, targeted supplemental lighting to save heating costs and increase productivity, making the most of available space with rolling benches, multi-layer cropping, and conserve water, fertilizer, and labor with drip irrigation, recirculating irrigation, and hydroponics. You will find that you are not only growing sustainable crops that consumers are looking for, but you will also be conserving valuable resources and protecting our environment for generations to come.